Hello and welcome back to the Elektor stage here, the Fast Forward stage by Electronica and Elektor, where we've had the opportunity to meet some of the startups who are attending here with us as part of the Elektor booth as guests. And first up, I'd like to welcome Quadruped, and they're a spin-off of My Bot Shop, which specializes in the development and distribution of research and development components. And with Quadruped, they focus more on application development of multi-legged robots, as you see here in front of me, especially based on unitary products. If you could come up to me, let's have a chat. Your pet is already greeting. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, thanks.
Are you getting what you want out of this fair? Are you having fun?
Yeah, it's very nice. You have very good talks right now. So everybody is very interested in what we're doing and a lot of nice topics out there.
Yeah, well, you've brought a few of our robot overlords here. So we're trying to make friends as much as we can. And what are you hoping to get out of this?
Could you please repeat?
What are you hoping to get out of this week at Electronica?
Okay, thank you. We are quite interested in which other fields we would like to explore right now. And we are right now in a very niche sector and still interested what our clients may be interested in to develop the product further and expand the market.
And so you're more leaning on the software side of things. Unitary, it provides a lot of your hardware. What made you lean towards Unitary?
Yeah, right. So Unitary is a Chinese company. So the robot is built in China. And we are mostly focused on the application development, especially software, because our customers usually don't use the robot as it is when it comes delivered. They would like to target special applications like security, for which they are needing, for example, a thermal camera to detect objects in the night. And we are doing the software solution for autonomous navigation as well as integrating the camera and building applications out of it. Let's if you need a GUI, whatever.
And what size is your team? It seems like a lot of development work.
No. We're a very small, dedicated team. We're around 15 to 20 guys, mostly with engineering background. And yeah.
Well, that's quite an achievement to get all that done with such a small team. Before I let you go, nobody would forgive me if I didn't say, show us some tricks, please.
Of course.
There we go. Leapfrog. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Our next startup, the booth right next door to Quadruped, is SpeedPox. SpeedPox offers innovative and ultra-fast curing epoxy resins, conductive adhesives, and inks. Their epoxies are one component systems with practically unlimited pot life at room temperature. Upon a heat or a UV stimulus, a patented self-propagating mechanism is triggered, which helps to save 99% of time and energy. Instead of several hours in an industrial furnace, they enable curing within seconds. Welcome.
Thanks a lot for this kind introduction, and it will be quite tough, but after the nice robotic show, so no jumping here, but maybe I can convince your audience also with some nice products from us.
Yeah, absolutely. We don't expect you to do any leapfrogging, but tell me about SpeedPox. One thing I noticed here is you said a single material. Well, how is that different? I mean, I'm used to using epoxy that have more than one material involved.
Yeah, so the traditional epoxies contain like two components. One is the so-called hardener, and the other one is really the epoxy itself. So what you have to do as a customer, you basically have to be a chemist. So what you do is you mix these two materials, and as soon as you mix them, the chemical time is ticking. So then you're doing a polymerization, the material solidifies at your site. What we are doing is we do the mixing process for you. So you get a one component ready to use solution from us, you can buy it, and then you have endless time. So I think there the keyword is curing on demand. So you as a customer decides, okay, when will this liquid product get solid? And you can do it either with UV light or with heat. And this is what we're selling exactly.
Ah, okay. So it's not a chemical reaction, but you use UV or heat. And let's say I were to ask you for your elevator pitch. You've got something there to show us. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, I think this is very innovative from us because this is conductive ink, but we also have conductive adhesives. And so far, yes, there are conductive inks and conductive adhesives on the market, but what we can offer with our innovative curing technology is a UV curable conductive adhesive. And what's our vision there? So at the moment, in surface mounted assembly lines, you're using solder paste. Yeah. And the solder paste has to go into a solder oven, so-called reflow oven. So you need a lot of temperature. Now, if you have heat-sensitive components or you want to reduce your energy, then we pitch and propose that you can get rid of your oven and just use UV light. And that's also how we can get to these numbers, like 99% of energy saved. Actually, it's way more. So if you compare just one UV lamp with a solder oven, it's 99.99999% of energy you can save quite easily. And we developed this product, especially our conductive adhesive, so that you can really replace your solder paste one-to-one. So the process before stays exactly the same. You have the same properties as the solder paste, so no additional costs. You just source the material from us, replace the solder paste, and all you need is a UV lamp, and you can get rid of oven. You get a lot of free space and can really speed up your production line.
So 99.99, that sounds almost far-fetched, but I believe you. That's a lot of energy saved. And are you enjoying the fair so far? Are you getting what you need out of it?
Yes, I think it's very interesting. It's very good to just dive into this nice atmosphere here, also at the booth, to get a lot of traffic. And it's not only about finding customers, it's also for us a lot about finding partners. Because the final customer actually normally has a product in mind or a vision, but you need many people and you have to get many people, and also we need many, many other very, very dedicated people to produce these products. So what we need are contract manufacturers. We need people who know how to dispense, how to print, how to stencil print. So it's quite complex and quite complex projects we're normally working on with several people to really offer a final solution, because we are just a part of the solution provider. We have to team up to really bring this innovation on the road.
Yeah, all the cogs in the machine have to work together. Anyway, thank you very much. That was SpeedPox giving us their little elevator pitch with an impressive product.
Thanks a lot. And also thanks a lot that we can be here. And it's a very, very, very nice exhibition so far. And looking forward for the next 4 days.
And good luck with the contest. Up next, we have Icecap, and their goal is to develop compact cooling system for widespread application within various products. And they use novel assembly techniques and innovative optimization algorithms for multi-stage thermoelectric modules. And lower temperatures can be achieved in smaller packages, allowing for easy integration within portable devices. Applications include high-speed cameras, radio receivers, telescopes, medical transporters, benchtop lab equipment, and high-performance processes, amongst others. Now, welcome.
Thank you for the introduction. We are very excited to be presenting our debut product at the Fast Forward booth. This is, in fact, our IP, as you mentioned, is based on optimization algorithms, as well as isolation, thermal isolation. We came up with this product to embody the algorithm to make it easy to implement and more accessible for all. So
the need for cold in many applications is widespread, more than I thought about. Telescopes, for example, you know, thermal noise you don't want in a telescope, and you mentioned in your presentation keeping the cold chain. Now how much of a challenge is that if you don't have a system like yours?
So in case of imaging, you're going to have what's known as dark current noise. So you'd want that your integrated circuit to perform consistently. So what we do was to cool the image sensor with Peltier devices and you make sure that it's, for example, the constant minus 20 degrees Celsius. That way you have a clean image in case of for imaging. And in terms of cold chain, the idea is to use battery packs. So you can, so basically converting DC to cooling performance in a very compact and simplified form factor. So in places where there isn't much infrastructure, cooling infrastructure, the product might shine where it creates relative simplicity. Just charge a battery, plug it in, and it's cooling your payload, and you're good to go.
Okay, so very useful in third world. And for example, when you've got to move medical samples or things like that, they've got to be kept cold, and you're on the road in the tropics, and something like that could be helpful.
Yeah, definitely. This is something which we are currently testing in-house, which is making use of this controller along with a customized setup of insulation and the form factor, which will create better ergonomic advantages where you can plug in the battery, monitor the temperature, really to simplify the whole process where the users don't need to handle stuff like dry ice, for example.
So software optimization helps keep things cool.
Yes, and also find the most efficient operational point to boost battery life, for example.
So who would have thought software to keep things cool and obviously enhance battery life, very useful in many scenarios where you might not have access to a generator or a cold truck or something like that. So it's an exciting product, and I wish you luck in the rest of this week. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. And that was Icecap, which is an appropriate name for their product. Our next contender is BTRY. It's BTRY. So there was some debate about how to pronounce them. Welcome.
Thank you very much for this opportunity. BTRY is perfect.
BTRY, yeah. It's a Swiss startup, and it's a spin-off of ETH Zurich. The company develops a thin, customizable solid-state battery with a unique combination of high energy and power to meet the needs of IoT, medicine technology again, and consumer electronics. And the product is an advanced lithium ion battery that can be charged and discharged apparently within 1 minute. I'd love to see that on any of the devices I use. It operates very high and low temperatures and can sustain several thousand cycles. How did you manage to pull that off?
Yeah, so the trick in the end is that we are using semiconductor fabrication methods to build our battery. So this is not traditionally used for battery manufacturing, but gives us some unique advantages. It's a lithium metal solid state battery in the end, and there comes the cycle life, but also the fast charge and discharge.
Okay, and several thousand cycles in 1 minute. You know, I was thinking like for electric cars, they take so long to charge, maybe just pull into the gas station and they swap out the batteries. But do you think this technology can be expanded to, you know, larger battery cells like in electric cars?
Yes. So in principle, there is nothing blocking it. However, the semiconductor fabrication methods we use need some time to fabricate the battery in the end after all. And there's, of course, also the problem that you need to scale this. The machines required for this already exist. We are testing them right now. However, I don't see our technology being used in car anytime soon. We're focusing on sensors now, but as you mentioned, maybe for medtech and consumer electronics along the road.
Now, that's just me dreaming big, but how are your clients?
So currently, we sold our first batteries for medtech applications, actually. And there, the solid state nature, so the safety was actually a key performance indicator for our customer. However, we are mostly looking at smart cards as a product. Okay, yes. So it's very small. This is the problem with small. our battery is thinner than a human hair on a cell level. So the whole package, 0.1 millimeter. This is very useful for a smart card. Survives the lamination temperatures and can really be as a rechargeable battery for supply chain monitoring in smart cards, be a game changer in that regard.
Oh, that's very impressive. I'm sorry we didn't bring one of our lab microscopes to have a closer look at that. But thank you for joining us. And again, good luck with the contest and the rest of the week.
Thank you. And you.
And our final startup with another very interesting product is Banyan.Eco. Welcome up on stage.
Hi. Nice to be here.
Yeah, nice to have you as well. some bullet points on you. You got product carbon footprints in seconds. I saw some of the demo earlier, instead of months sometimes. CSRD ready company carbon footprints and eco design monetization and digital product passports.
Absolutely. And that's because one of the things about the electronics ecosystem is it's very complex. So you might need a microscope for this one as well. This cellular module has over 120 components under it. And working out the product carbon footprint for this is very complex and takes weeks. But we all use commercial off-the-shelf components. So why reinvent the wheel? And Banyan.Eco actually uses the collective intelligence of the electronics ecosystem so that everybody gets to a better knowledge on emissions faster. And we do that using AI. And that's the reason for the name Banyan.Eco as well. The banyan is a tree that actually drops down roots from the branches and expands horizontally to create a mutual ecosystem. That's what we want to do with Banyan.Eco to make it electronic sustainable.
Yeah, and you're dropping roots into the ground and you're serving your clients, but making your clients is not where it ends. Your clients' clients are happy, and that's what's important.
Absolutely, absolutely. And because the electronics chain is quite complex, and especially for European CSRD reporting, customers ask their suppliers, what's your product carbon footprint? And a supplier that has the answers for this and is forward-leaning in terms of eco-design is considered favorably by their customers. So absolutely right. We are making our customers happy and our customers' customers happy.
Yeah, and that's very important. And how much efficiency do you think you're freeing up? I can't ask you in exact dollars and cents, but when you take 6 months of compliance and you do that in seconds, that must make a huge difference.
Yeah, so we typically calculated, let's say an average company that has about 30 or 40 SKUs, which is par for the course for an electronics company, probably will cost them about 600 to 700,000 euros for this. We would probably go down to 20% of that that cost level.
Oh, that's amazing. So I hope you're impressing people here at the fair. Have you been getting a lot of fun and productivity out of it?
Yes, indeed. And we actually had one of our leading clients, and they allowed us to mention it, Secor. So they're a big EMS that's also in the hall just across. And the CEO just dropped by. We've been working very closely with them and really happy with the collaboration with them as well.
Well, that's amazing. The CEO dropped by. So I hope you can top that in the rest of the week. And have a lot of fun. And again, good luck with the rest of the week and the contest.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
So that was Banyan.Eco. Thank you for joining us. And now you've seen the startups competing here at the Elektor Fast Forward by Electronica and Elektor. It's going to be an interesting week watching them networking here and organically reaching out. And then we will see at the end of the week how the contest goes. But I hope that gave you a valuable insight into who's competing and what they're doing. And stay tuned at electoral.tv, and we'll have a look the rest of the week and show you what's happening here at Electronica, not just with the startups, not just with Fast Forward, but we'll have many live shows and meet makers and designers and all that sort of thing. So we'll keep in the loop. Stay right here on Electoral TV.